In less than 6 hours, fishermen will begin casting their nets for the state's second biggest marine industry.
Elver fishing, we're talking about, and it brought in $40 million for Maine fishermen last year alone. News 8's Thema Ponton is live this morning in Waldenboro with a closer look at the beginning of the season. Good morning, Thema.
Well, good morning, Aaron and Shannon. Some Elver fishermen have been camped out here along the Medomic River in Waldenboro for more than a week as they try to get the best position to catch the young eels when the season begins at noon today. Now, Maine's eel fishing season started strongly last year when prices rocketed to above $2,000 a pound. And with prices like that, the season can be rather competitive. Now, the state only has 400 Elver fishing licenses. But this year, for the first time since 2006, the state held a lottery for one of only four open licenses. More than 5,000 people applied for those spots. However, with a $2,000 fine for anyone caught Elver fishing without a license, Marine Patrol officials say it might not be enough to stop some people.
But I don't know if that's going to be a deterrent. I mean, there's just so much money that people are making some nights that they're willing to take that chance. They just can't resist the money that's being made right now. And the Marine Patrol offices will be real busy for the next 9 to 10 weeks.
Now, once caught, the Elvers are shipped to Asia to be raised and sold to restaurants and retailers. Now, one Marine Patrol official says that he's heard from dealers and fishermen that eels could go for $2,000 to $3,000 a pound this season, but that's hard to tell until the season gets underway. Now, officials believe one reason for the high price for the eels is due to the tsunami in Japan back in 2011, which devastated eel stocks. Now, Maine and South Carolina are the only two states in the country where Elver fishing is allowed, and Maine's Elver fishing season runs until noon on May 31st. In Waldenboro, I'm Thema Ponton, News 8.